So welcome back to my channel. Here we have two types of tissue, epithelial tissue and connective tissue. So the epithelial tissue here is the epidermis of the skin, and it is stratified squamous, keratinized epithelium, the keratin being what is here on top. And then now you have the epidermal pads and you have the dermal papillae. What you have in terms of the apical specialization is the cilia, the microvilli and the spherocilia. This is respiratory epithelium, so you can be able to see the pseudostratified columnar ciliated epithelium with goblet cells which produce mucus. The cartilage that lacks the pericondium is the femoral cartilage and articular cartilage, and the one that does have the pericondium is hyaline cartilage and elastic cartilage. Remember, articular cartilage is hyaline cartilage that is found in synovial joints. Then you have anatomical differences between thick and thin skin. Thick skin has the stratum lucidum and the stratum corneum. The non-muscle cells that are contractile include the myoid cell, myofibular cells, and myofibroblasts. So we have a slide of the artery here, so you can see the tunica intima, tunica media, and tunica adventitia. You can appreciate the circumvallate papillae with test buds, and these are the circumvallate grooves. So this is the lung, so you can be able to see the airway, or you can be able to see the alveoli basically. And remember, there are three cell types, type 1, type 2, type 3. And of note is that type 2 is also regenerative. So this is a slide of the retina, so you can be able to see all the 10 layers. And then you can appreciate that there are various cell types. Remember, these cell types support, the amacrine support the ganglion, the horizontal support the bipolar neurons. And the photoreceptor cells include the rods and the cones. You can appreciate the cerebellum here, so from outside going in on the molecular, papinje, and the inner granular layer of the cerebellar cortex. And so what you can appreciate here is the liver, the central vein, the sinusoids, and the hepatic plate system. And here is the uterus, so you can be able to appreciate the endometrial layer, which is thickened because of the proliferative phase under the effect of estrogen. And then you can be able to see the myometrium. So this is actually the sympatibular glands that are prominent at this phase. Thank you, and if there's any question, you can leave them on the comment section below.